You were the word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you are Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, for Jesus, you brought heaven. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares.
Before you, you silence the boast of sin and grave.
The heavens are roaring the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival. You have
telegrafen. How many?
Three.
Please stand. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord,
both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Good afternoon, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Please sit as we shall now have the tributes. We have the tributes.
Good afternoon. My name is Kiana, and I am one of Evelyn's younger nieces. On behalf of the family, I want to extend gratitude to all the attendees who have come here today to honor this great woman, my aunt, Evelyn Simpson. Remember me. To the limit, to the living, I am gone. To the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated, but to the happy, I am at peace. And to the fearful, I have never left. I cannot speak, but I can listen. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. Soon as you stand upon a shore gazing at a beautiful sea, as you look upon a flower and admire a simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, and your memories of the time we love, the time we cry, the time we fought, the time we laugh. For if you always think of me, I will never have gone. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ingrid Maskell. Me and Evelyn would have gone way back for the time in the 90s. It's a tragedy to lose a friend so soon, but what would have been worse is if we would have never met her. Evelyn was joyful. Evelyn could just light up a room. And I was so grateful to have been Evelyn's friend in life and will continue to be her friend in death, honoring her in all I do. Evelyn, we would all remember that chuckle and that smile that would lighten the room. Your life was a blessing, and your memory will remain in our hearts. We are deeply saddened but grateful for the time we had spent with you. Our beloved friend, you may have left us far too soon, but God is always on time. Your presence will endure forever in our hearts. Sleep on, Evelyn. Rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Joy Headley, and I'm a very dear friend of Evelyn. And today we are gathered here so to honor and celebrate her life. On behalf of Evelyn's children, grandchildren, and relative, I would like to express heartfelt gratitude and appreciation to all in attendance here today, both physically and virtually, and all those who showed their love and support at this extremely sad time in our lives. Evelyn was the daughter of the late Irene Simpson and Glenville Eswick. But to everyone, she was Bob and Kay's daughter. She was born on the 30th of July, 1964, and was the mother of three children, Alicia, Nicola, and Tristan, and grandmother of five. She also had eight siblings. As most of you may know, Evelyn grew up in the nearby Gall Hill community and attended the St. John Mixed School. She was my childhood friend. even though heavy set, it was amazing that she still managed to take part in every activity that was accessible in the community: netball, volleyball, etc. When roller skating was introduced, Her friend Diana bought 2 pairs of roller skates and they practiced on them. When she get better, the 2 of them will make it 3 times weekly. It was their routine to travel down to Bridgetown to the 2 skating arenas, Studio 10 and Skate On. Yvonne was always up for challenge and adventure. She somehow always managed to outdo the smaller skaters, especially when one of her favorite songs was played, Don't Rock the Boat, Baby. The netball boys and girls of all in our community love her companionship, which will be no more, but at least we have memories that we live on. Evelyn bore many names, 2 of which she wasn't christened. In the 70s, a few young men from St. Vincent who came here to harvest sugarcane at the nearby Colleton Plantation, Desmond, Leo, and Delplech, named her Bernice, as they somewhat found it difficult to call her name. In January 2000, I took Evelyn to work at Designer Decor, and she remained there up to the time of her passing 23 years later. The name Eugene was given to her by her then supervisor, Michael, which has stuck with her throughout the years, even to this day, so now that I still call her Eugene. Like all of us do, we have our bad and good traits. At times, she was not the easiest to get along with. She had a way with words, but at times had to be cautioned about the kinds of words and language she used. She was cold, she was chastised, ignored, but that wasn't for long, as she was the life of the party. I remember those phone calls to be filled in on the latest happenings. She was my Pearly, I was her Lottie. We had fun. One of my most fond memories of Evelyn was when I was about to start my catering business. It wasn't registered, but one day she was in the company of some others, and she overheard a conversation about with 2 couples that she was there were getting married and they needed someone to cook. She said, "But I know a good cook. I'll get one for you." They exchanged numbers and she called me. She said, "Somebody's going to call you." The guy called me. He said, "I heard about you, but are you registered?" I said, "No." He said, "Go and get registered." I did. But I called Evelyn and I said to her, the guy called me, you know, "What do you think I should name it?" She said, "Since you and Susan and I usually be going around together, we're going to be doing the little thing, I think you should name it Joy, Susan, and Evelyn." And with that, Jesse Caterers was formed. It was registered. And today, I want to thank her for that. Okay. Evelyn was the people's person. She made friends easily and sought to keep those friendships alive. Alicia and Nicole would always joke about the time it took on them to walk an hour from Fairchild Street bus terminal to approach in the QEH. On that trek, everyone that passed either knew Evelyn or knew Evelyn knew them. And believe you me, she stopped to have a conversation with each and everyone. She possessed some good qualities which cannot be ignored. If you want someone to plait your hair, she did it. Someone to take care of you, she was there. Someone to clean house, she was there. Someone to take along as a partner, she readily accepted. Some of you here today can agree with me that I can say Eugene helped you keep your job or pick a day's work by being your babysitter. She did all of this from her heart, never looking for anything in return. Even in her final days and hospital stays, although she was not well herself, she still tried to assist other patients and make sure they were okay. One of her newest friends, Anne, who she met on A1, said, "She left an empty space in me, even though we had just met. She was truly a nice person who would do anything for everyone." Alicia's chair mom asked her both trip. Alicia shared, "Mom, as her both children and grandchildren call her, was the epitome of tough love. No matter what, Mom always showed love in the best way she knew. She especially loved her grandchildren dearly." Alicia's fond memory of her mom was her aunt saying, "You have your keys? Do you have your phone? Cause you know you. or coming home exhausted to find her room tidy with clothes washed and folded even as a doll. Nicole's fond memory of her mom was her excitedly asking her to take pictures, and with each one was, mom was saying, another one, I do not like that, you like that? While waiting for her aunt to come and pick her up to go on one of her many outings. Tristan mentioned he remembered mom always took him to senior games or to watch the bands on the Black Rock Main Road. Kankaduma there with joy. On closing remarks, it was great gratitude. I want to thank all those who at her most difficult times lend a helping hand. Alicia stated, if I never believe that saying of do good and it will return unto you, I do know. My mother's love is a testament to such. During her illness on the wards and at home, I saw many of her friends came through for her, at times leaving me in total awe. One thing I kept telling my mom, you are so blessed, and I hope you know it. She would respond, yes, I know. I was good to people, you know. The past 7 months, Evelyn's health deteriorated gradually until she became withdrawn, weak, and very dependent on others until her passing on June the 18th, 2023. However, her faith in God grew. Alicia recounted one day her mom called her from the hospital and said, Alicia, I was feeling so bad today, and I said the prayer you gave me, and I felt so much better. She sounded so hopeful. It is with heavy hearts that we say goodbye to Evelyn. However, on the bright side, she's now free from her pain and suffering. So now I say goodbye to a mother, a sister, an aunt, or a friend. May you rest in eternal peace. You will be missed. At this time, I wish to offer special thanks to Pastor Shirley Griffith, who was able to pray with Evelyn as she transitioned to paradise. The staff of the AKU unit of the Queen Elizabeth Hospital, Ward C9 and A1, Dr. Diana Holder. Sheriff family and friends who supported, prayer for and with Evelyn and the family in numerous ways. Thank you. May she rest in peace.
Please stand for the reception of the body. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Evelyn. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Through all the changing scenes of life, hymn 427. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please sit for the first Bible reading.
Good evening. The reading from the Word of God written in the book of Lamentations 3, 22 to 26 and 31 to 33. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to the end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the souls that seek him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord, for the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love, for he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. The word of the Lord.
We shall remain sitting as we sing the Crimon version of Psalm 23. Second Bible reading.
Good evening. Our reading from the Word of God written in John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The word of the Lord.
We shall stand as we sing the hymn "Before the Address, the Strife is O'er," hymn 182.
Good evening. You may be seated. Good evening. I'm Pastor Shirley Griffith of Life in Salvation Ministries. And I want, first of all, on behalf of our senior minister, Pastor Grantley Griffith, and our leaders and members, to express our deep condolence to Sister Evelyn's children, Nicole, Tristan, Alicia, the grandchildren, all of the siblings, and you special friends and other family members. I declare God's comfort over you at this time as you grieve the passing of this loved one. This evening, I'm not going to be long, so you don't have to fall asleep. I'm going to be delivering a message that I believe that God is sending to this house this evening. And I'm going to be speaking to you concerning the word at 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 and 14. And that word reads as follows: "Brothers and sisters, do not be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, so we believe that God will bring Jesus with him for those who have fallen asleep in him. Hallelujah. And this evening, I want to encourage you in the words of Paul to the Thessalonians. I want to encourage you today with these words. Now, Paul spoke to these Thessalonians concerning the loss of a loved one, one who had died. It seemed like the Thessalonians had very little knowledge of death of a saint and what would eventually happen to them also. It would seem that they thought that when you die, you would be at some disadvantage compared to those who remained on earth. So Paul's response was, I would not have you ignorant to those who have fallen asleep. This evening, I want to join Paul, and I would not have you ignorant here at St. John's Parish Church this evening about those who have fallen asleep like our sister Evelyn. Paul did not want them to remain in the dark, and this evening, I don't want you to remain in the dark. As it's repeated in this scripture, falling asleep. And as we all know, sleep and falling asleep depicts a situation that is temporary. How many of you know that when you fall asleep in Jesus Christ, it is temporary? Evelyn has fallen asleep in Christ. Why can I say that? I had the opportunity to be with Evelyn in one of her earliest days at the hospital. And I had the opportunity to share this Christ with Evelyn. And I saw Evelyn bow her head, broke out into tears, and receive Jesus Christ as her Savior. So with that in place, with that as her, as my remembrance of her, where she committed at that time her life to the Lord, I take the opportunity to say that she has fallen asleep in Jesus Christ. I also had the opportunity to see Evelyn in her very last hours on the face of the earth and to reconfirm that commitment with a faint squeezing of her hands, confessing that she could still hear and still hold on to this Jesus Christ. So this evening, we see her here. She's absent, but she has been received by our loving Savior. She may be absent, but she is present with the Almighty God. When we give our lives over to God, when we spend time on earth putting Him first, when in this existence we decide to choose to serve Him, to trust Him, and to follow Him, when we make these choices, we have the opportunity that when death comes, that we too can say, absent from the body, but present in the everlasting arms of Jesus. She's not lost. This evening is not an evening of doom and gloom. We may shed a tear here and there because we have memories. We will miss her. But I know that this is a celebration. This is a celebration of the fact that the crucifixion of Jesus Christ and the resurrection gives us all the assurance that we too can be resurrected. He is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. So as I tell you this evening, it is not a watered-down version of God who received Evelyn. It is not a watered-down version of God who received us. It's the same God. So many of us might walk around, you know, still expressing shock at death. I hear it over and over again. Well, I can't believe he dead. Or I can't believe she dead. I just talked to she last week. I just spoke to her a few hours ago. But I'm here to remind you, my friend, that death waits on no man. Death takes who he wants, when he wants. Death does not have respect for color or for creed or for masters or degrees. Death does not have respect for your position in life. When death is ready for me, it will take me. When death is ready for you, you have to go. There's no hiding place from it. It can take you straight off of American Airlines plane heading to New York for a vacation. It can take you quietly as you sleep. Death will take anyone. It will take a deacon. It will take a vagrant off of the streets. It will take a doctor who we run to prevent death. It will take a child. It will take a pastor, a president, a billionaire. Death does not care. It appears as though death have some kind of free reign. It would appear that death does not discriminate. And no one on the face of this earth can tell death what to do, it would appear. But I'm here to tell you this evening that over 2,000 years ago, a man called Jesus Christ went to the cross of Calvary. He was nailed to the cross and he took the sting out of death. Death could not overtake him until he gave it away to him. In Luke chapter 23, verses 46, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, I commit my soul into your hands." Death could not take him before he uttered those words. Jesus said, "I commit my spirit into your hands." Death has to be subjected and commanded by the power of Jesus Christ. Death, the word that makes us so afraid sometimes. But when Jesus was buried and he rose on the third day, he transferred a resurrection power that death cannot hold even us down as we walk in a relationship with him. Death can hold no captive saints. There's only one death if you are entering into a relationship and committed to a relationship with Jesus Christ. You shall know death no more. This evening, those who are willing to really accept this Jesus Christ, those who are willing to make Jesus Christ a part of their lives, those who are willing to be in an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ right here on the face of this earth, he continues to knock. Those who believe that whosoever will shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The word of God says that Jesus is the resurrection. He is the first to be risen from the dead. And because of that, he has made a way for you and me to also be resurrected. The offer and the choice this evening is on the table. We might simply feel that we came to a funeral, but what we have come to is again Jesus knocking at the hearts of our lives. The choice is set before us. Today I set before you life and death. And he didn't make it difficult because the scriptures say, choose life. The choice is here, and we can enjoy it once we have the breath in our lungs. Jesus declared that he is the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in him, even though he may die, he will still live. Wow, what a promise this evening. Our sister has fallen asleep in Jesus Christ. But even though it looks like death, because she opened her heart to him while she still had breath, she can say that it seems as though she's dead, but the Bible tells us she has life and she has eternal life. It's the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead that he's offering for it to dwell in us. The resurrection this evening is not an event. It is actually the person, Jesus Christ. We too can have everlasting life, but we must understand that one day, as we place our lives in the hand of God, that we too can rise again. If you believe that Jesus Christ rose from the dead, the wages of sin may be death, and we all have to pay those wages. But I have good news for you this evening. The gift of God is eternal life. And all those who receive Jesus in their life will arise from this sleep called death. Let's be the resurrected into everlasting life this evening. God wants us to be with him. He prepared a way. And all we have to do is take the steps in that direction. Let us examine our own mortality and understand that we too have to face death this evening. Everyone in here, most likely, unless the sound of the trumpet comes before, we will have to face death. I know this evening that most of you would not prefer to talk about that. We'll prefer to talk about Evelyn. But I'm telling you that death is coming. We cannot push it back in the back part of our mind. The reality is that one day, all of us will die. It could be this year. It could be this month. It could be this week. My friends, it could be today. It could be an hour from now. I attended a funeral, and before it was finished, one person who attended had to prepare for their own funeral. It could be the last day to be here on this earth. So as we run around with our busy schedules, from the moment our feet hit the ground on mornings, you know there's a clock ticking, there's a clock running, you have to do this, you have to do that, TikTok, everything, get the children to school, get a bath, get to work. So many things are on our minds. We're saying the days are shorter because there's so much that we are doing. But as that clock ticks, I want to tell you, church, there is another clock that is ticking over our lives. A clock that has no interest in your economic status, your social background, your personal plans, or your age, or your health conditions. We often like to ask, oh, what happened that she died? What happened was the wages of sin, and we have all fallen short of the glory of God. We are all sinners saved by grace. We are all on a collision course with death. Why would we play with something so serious? We go in our houses and we make sure every door is locked at night, trying to protect our possessions. Why do we play with our eternal destination? Death does not care what you've left undone. Reality is that we can live for a long time, but reality is that death could be around the corner. We prepare for everything else, our weddings, we prepare for our work, we prepare for all kinds of events. Let us prepare our lives to be with Jesus Christ. Many people had nothing drastically wrong with them. They simply lay down to rest and never got up. They did not have a chance to get it together. Sister Evelyn had a chance and a moment. But the reality is that we cannot bet on a chance. We cannot bet on an opportunity at the end of our lives. We cannot bet on a last minute entrance. Let's make it right now. My assignment is to tell you in these few moments and to shout the alarm. I want to shout it to you. Tomorrow is not promised. Moses died, Abraham died, all the disciples died. I will die and you will die. We may not even want to hear it. We may not even want to think about it. But the truth is, it's the most important thing that should be on our minds concerning how we live. The only thing we have, friends, the only thing we have is right now. We can't refuse it. Church, let us face it. There's a day already marked in history that will be the last day for you and me on this planet called Earth. Don't refuse it. The greatest trick that the enemy has played and continue to play time after time is to tell us that we have time. I don't have to do it now. As I evangelize, people say, as I get older, I'll do it next time. I'm not ready. I hear it so many times, I'm not ready. But let me tell you something. Death does not care if you are ready or not. Death says, ready or not, here I come. Have you asked yourself what will happen when you die? If you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you might know the answer to that and like it. If you don't, you might also know the answer, but you might not like it. There is too much at stake. It is in this life where we still have breath in our nostrils. I'm sure you are there breathing. You can feel that breath in your nostrils. This is the time to make the decision. This is the time to confess Jesus Christ as Lord, as Savior, to believe in our hearts that Jesus Christ rose from the dead, to break the chains of sin over our lives, and to receive Him in our hearts as a Master. It is in this life that making such a decision will determine your eternal destination. As I talk to you this evening, I want to challenge you. What are you going to do with the message that you are hearing? There's an eternal status available. You know, our status on our cell phone disappears in 24 hours. But there's an eternal status. There's an eternal place for you. That Jesus said, I've gone to prepare a place for you, that where I am, the eternal God of the universe wants us to be where He is. It's promised by Almighty God who has created you. And one day we will be called to it. We will take our last breath. I know this evening that I'm not giving you new information, but I'm asking you not to be misled by the temporary things in this world. Those things that the moss and the rust will take away. Temporary. We are so caught up sometimes fighting for houses, lands, and material things that we forget that they're only temporary. Material things that would be only of value in this short life. But what God is offering us is eternity, something that cannot compare with time. I want to tell you this evening that you can die without a car. You can die without a house. Ladies, you can die without a husband, without children. Husband, you can die without a wife. You can die without a bank account. You can die without your sight. You can die without your hearing. You can die with one leg or no legs. You can die without kidneys. And it really wouldn't matter. But I'm here to tell you this evening that if you die without Jesus Christ, it will matter. The Bible tells us in John 3:16 that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish. The floodgates are open and all inclusive. Whosoever believes, we all have access. God cares about us. He loves us. The Bible says He so loved the world. We can enter into His arms. His word is telling us, fear not, because God is with us. We do not have to walk as a dismayed people. We can cast our cares upon Him. This evening I'm talking to you about a God who cares about you. Do not be anxious about anything. If He took care of the birds of the air, He will take care of you. It is He who made you and not you yourself. A choice for Jesus Christ is a rich choice this evening. It is a choice that you will not regret. He is the way, church. He is the life. He comes, we come nowhere to God but through Jesus Christ. I know that so many of you might be sitting here and facing all kinds of circumstances, carrying all kinds of burdens. Even as I speak to you, I feel like people are having medical conditions and diagnoses that are difficult. Marriages are in trouble. Maybe you're having trouble with your children, financial situations. Maybe you feel like if you want to give up, but there's hope. There's one called Jesus Christ who cares about you, who loves you unconditionally, who's calling you now, who set you at this funeral at this particular time so that you can answer His call. Those who live for Christ prove that they are willing to enter into eternity with Him. It is guaranteed, my friends. It is guaranteed. God is a rescuer. He placed a rescue plan in place for all of us. Jesus is the answer. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, After death, we'll all have a divine appointment with the Almighty God. We'll have to wake up. Sister Evelyn will have to get up. All the persons in your life, because I know you've experienced that, they have to get up to this divine appointment. And it is set with the Almighty God. This is an appointment that cannot be canceled. This is an appointment that cannot be rescheduled, my friends. This is an appointment that you cannot be late for. It is a divine appointment, an appointment where we are all going to stand before the Almighty God and give an account of our deeds done here in this body on the face of the earth, whether good or whether bad in his sight. For he's the righteous judge. God is the righteous judge. He will judge you. You see, people will see you and judge you unjustly from the outside. But God will judge us in our inner parts. He knows the motives of our hearts. People, we look to God. Let not your past hold you back, church. There's nothing that you could do that is so horrible. It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you've done. The cleansing power of God is available through Jesus Christ to us all. This evening, I leave you with the opportunity to examine your heart. Don't waste another day. Don't waste another moment. We are still alive. We still have a choice. The time to receive Jesus Christ and have that relationship that leads to eternity is now. There's nobody who's laying in a coffin or grave in any parish church that still has the opportunity. Nobody at Coral Ridge have the opportunity. Nobody laying in graves at Westbury Cemetery or wherever you're buried. Those opportunities are closed. Yours is still open. Make a decision that is the most important decision that you could ever make in your life. Follow Sister Evelyn when the opportunity was given to her, just as I am giving it to you now. She chose life. No, I can't stand here because I was there. I'm not here in third party. She chose life. So she can know that when the trumpet song and the dead in Christ rise first, that she will be a part of the first procession going up. You can also be a part of it. All that you think matters, really don't. There's one key thing that matters: how you live your life and accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I bless you. I declare life over you. I declare your heart softened. I declare that you will receive the word that God has sent to this house at this time. Thank you very much.
And now let us stand and proclaim our faith together in the words of the Apostles' Creed on page 4 of your booklet. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. During the singing of this next hymn, there will be a collection for the upkeep of the church cemetery. Hymn 496, And Can It Be That I Should Gain?
Thank you.
response to the bidding, Lord, in your mercy, will be hear our prayer, hear our prayer. We pray for those who mourn and we commemorate the departed. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Show your mercy to the dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father of all, we pray to you for Evelyn and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May she and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let me take this opportunity to extend sincere condolences to you, the relatives and friends of our dear departed sister, and assure you of this church's prayerful support, and pray that you will continue to feel God's love and peace throughout your time of bereavement. Please remain standing for the commendation.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant,
your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Let us commend our sister Evelyn to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Evelyn, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Evelyn. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. The closing hymn, Angel Voices Ever Singing, hymn 363.
Angels are so rare. The Lord be with you. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the records of their deeds. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer, forgive us our sins. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure uncertain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, Evelyn, and we commit our body to the ground, earth to earth. And we beseech your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. That when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Evelyn, and we ourselves, may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Oh, temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who with all our sorrows shares? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. What are we weak and heavy made, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge is there.
Assurance.
Bless Lord, taste of glory divine, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, Savior, all the day long. This is all, praising my Savior, all the day long. Perfect submission.
Come, we that love the Lord. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing His mercy, and when we all get to heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, grace. perish with us.
I wanted you for life, you and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story would end. It's hard to understand, but I guess I'll have to try. It's not easy to say goodbye. For all the joy we shared, all that time we had to spend, if I had one wish, I'd want forever back again. To look into your eyes and hold you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I can remember all those great times we had. There were so many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories will last forever.
Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. And unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. May she and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
There's peace in where you are. Maybe all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I'll hear your laughter once more. And so I've got to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye.